just gonna go directly into it. What's that? That's annoying. Hey! Yeah! The biker! It's really good that he's not there, because then I don't have to waste time just, like, taking him out. Thank you. Hopefully I don't screw this up. Could have been worse. Yeah, thanks. I actually didn't get world record. I was down by, like, I really screwed up the final boss, and as a result, I was 11 seconds off of my personal best. Which, since I'm the only one running this game right now, is world record. But yeah, I was thinking about A3, and I was looking at, like, some of my really old runs back from like a year ago when I didn't really know much about what to do. And I didn't really experiment much. And I was thinking, you know, this stage is a real run-ender, and I don't like that I need to, like, risk so much right at the end. So I decided to experiment a bit more with the super bombs, and that's how it ended up. It's now, like, one of my favorite stages. I would suggest just trying to do that on your own. Like, it's not too complex, it's not like it's super technical, you just need like, I believe it's something like 1900 gold or 1550, I think. That's for the absolute minimum. But yeah, it's fun. Would highly recommend trying that stage. What? I heard it move to the right, and then it moved to the left, like, immediately afterwards. Gonna lose a little bit of time here, but... oh well. No fast forward, unfortunately. Or no two fast forwards. If you can, I'd highly recommend getting an original Xbox rather than the Xbox 360, because I've heard that it lags so much on that system. Yeah, No fast forward crystal? Yes, fast forward crystal. Awesome. Okay, that's good. If there's one thing that I should, like, tell you about speedrunning this game, it's to be prepared to, like, fail a lot. Like, just because the game is generally so hard, it's not like something that I'd say is discouraging, but in general, it is kind of tough to do stuff. Also, I wonder if I can just, like, lure him over here, because I don't need any fast, any time scrolls yet. Yeah, I can. Cool. Ooh, that's a lot of gold. Also, another thing for speedrunning, do you have Platinum Hits, or do you have the original version of the game? PAL version, does that mean that you're Europe? Or in Europe? Because I'm not actually sure if there's differences between NTSC and PAL. Haven't gotten the chance to try those out yet. Same thing happened as did in the last world. Whoops! I forgot that I need to keep that one octoballoon over there alive so that I can just look at the door while it's opening. Because otherwise that cutscene happens. Just gonna grab the record now, cause if I do need it for next stage, then I got it, and if I don't need it, then okay, so I have it for 5-2. Might as well grab the free gold. I'm gonna need to turn up my volume next time there's a loading screen. Because I can barely hear anything, and that's not going to help me in the later stages when I need to react to sound. Hopefully I get the clip. Perfect. That is a very good time. Like, in game, that was something like, 2:30, I think? That was awesome. Anyways, I'm not sure what's up with the game audio, because I can't exactly watch the stream itself. What?! Oh, what just happened?! Did I hit him? I think I hit. Whoa! I'm not sure what just happened. I think I hit him before he showed up, but like as the animation was starting. I'll take that. I didn't know that was a thing! Just from watching, I think that it seems like its hurtbox shows up before the animation does, and the hitbox that it does to hurt you doesn't come up until a little later. That's the only explanation that I can give, really. Also got perfect RNG here. That's pretty much the best trash that I can ask for. Didn't want him to duck down. Guess I'm gonna need to wait for him to do that first. Or I can just fire now. I'll get the octo balloon that's still in there a little later when I'm doing the shots. Anyways, after yesterday, I've learned the best order to do this. So first, I want to take care of the Karopper and the Water Slug here so that I don't need to worry about them later on. Good, everything went as desired there. Then I want to shoot there to cover the octoballoon. And double jump there to cover those guys. Then after that, I'm going to want to jump over here. Shoot the Chrono Blob, shoot the bomb over there to blow all those up, and beat the Karopper. Then I'm gonna wanna get a quick refill, and this guy should be back to hopping along. Huh! I opened the door accidentally. The gold was big enough to catch my attention, so I figured I might as well grab it. So, with the octoballoon at the beginning of the level, you can either have good RNG, meh RNG, or bad RNG. Good RNG is what happened before, where you get, like, that red bin with the wood things in them. The red bin with the wood planks in them, that's what I want to say. And that's good RNG because you can just directly go onto the... You can just directly jump onto it. Meh RNG is using the trash stacking to use just a normal red bin, because then that allows you to get high enough, and you need to spend a little bit more time to... get the red bin onto the bomb and put the bomb in the right place and do that stuff. And bad RNG is if you get basically anything else, and that's bad RNG because even if you trash stack, you can't get up there, and as a result, you need to restart. So the fact that I got the best RNG, like, immediately is very good. I'm gonna start collecting for retries. I have no idea what triggers the retry tutorial, and I haven't exactly gotten it yet, but... especially at this point, where I'm nearly out of hearts, half my lives, I wanna be cautious. Also gonna want to start thinking about slows, so I'm gonna go out of my way a little bit to grab that. This guy's gonna pop out, it should be in a safe bombing range. I guess I'm gonna grab the pause instead. Didn't get the shot. You know, what if I just fed him another bomb? That would probably be easier, considering I don't need the bomb anywhere else now. Good, I activated the Octoblink. Gonna grab that trash for one of the spikers later on. Gold split. Awesome. Do I have the gold that I need? Yes, awesome. That's perfect. I've yet to actually get to do this in a run, so that's nice. Uses Super Bomb in 4-3. There we go. Tis all gold dependent. Every single time I've had like 450, so not enough. That was the worst order that I could have gotten them. I was trying to get pause, pause, retry, rewind so that I could grab the three slow crystals individually. But that didn't happen. The game had other plans. Not the best positions they could have been in. You need to go around one in order to shoot. Not a gold split. Perfect. Hopefully I get the lock on this guy. Unfortunately, that's gonna reset his cycle. 5. 6 bounces, the traction dude. I was kind of worried that I didn't hit him there. Luckily, I did. I almost messed that up like twice. But luckily I did not. Yeah, he was about to go into his invincibility like the second time that I missed the shot. And that would have taken quite a lot longer to get out of. Okay, so that theory has been tested now. The theory that I wanted to test is, would I go into the falling the free fall animation if I did not go directly, if I wasn't directly below the slope. Because, once again, I don't exactly know what's exactly up with that. But turned out it was not gonna be like that. Anyways, now I really need to start driving slows, because otherwise I'm not gonna have time for them. Or be able to get them later. Since I'm gonna start needing them next stage. The Octoploon was right there and I only just noticed. If I saw it, then that could have saved time. Oh well. Awesome, I can grab two slugs. Yeah. Luckily, the free fall animation doesn't do much harm in this run, but I kind of want to figure out, like, what causes it and what can stop it, because that would definitely help. Save a couple more seconds, like, on 5-1, and I think that's it. How much gold do I have? 1501? Perfect. Actually, not perfect. Needed like 50 more. But at least I have the bombs that I need for most of the rooms. Oh boy, that was slightly scary. Did he fall through the world as soon as I was going to shoot the bomb? Cause that's the only explanation I have for why he didn't lose his life. At least I got the Morgan, that's like the really big one. I'm also gonna need to shoot out both of those pieces of trash so that I can super bomb the last one. I just noticed that there was a perfect opportunity here to grab it slow. Ah, messed that up. Oh! Well, if anything, at least I'm not using too many retries right now. I haven't really been hurting on them this run. Ah, there's a jump that I can make there, which saves a little bit of time, and since I was ahead, I figured I might as well try to go for it. But I missed it, so... that's gonna cost me a little bit of time. This is not going very well. Oh, come on! Well, I shouldn't have opened my mouth. Now I am hurting on retries. I'm gonna see if I have enough gold to buy, like, one. Because even if it's a time loss, it's less of a time loss than game overing. Luckily, I'm able to buy three. Wasn't sure how much I'd have enough for. 3 minutes to save on Everwinter? Yeah, something like that. Specifically Everwinter 7-2, because... on my first run, I spent something like 2 minutes just, like, messing that up. I also have a ton of time to save on the boss coming up. Because game over last time I did the run, and succeeded in the run. Anyways, I messed that up. No! Come on! This isn't turning out very well for me. In fact, I'm just gonna go the normal route because I'm not gonna lose all three rewinds right at the beginning. Because I need all of those rewinds. Or retries, not the rewinds. seems like for some reason that lighting there causes lag. My previous Temple of Lost Time 3 wasn't actually very good itself, so I'm probably still gonna save like a minute or so on this level, despite the really bad screw-ups early on, and the fact that I'm not doing very well like after that. Definitely set on slows, so that's good. I need a ton of slows for later in the game. It's weird how useful that time control gets, but for how condensed of a period it's used. Cause really, it's only useful during It's only very useful starting, like, this area, and then it keeps staying really useful for until the end of Minor Precious Moments, except then you stop needing it until for, like, one level in Forge of Hours. But like, because of how much it's used, a lot of it is needed, despite how few areas use them. That guy was very close. Still saved time, yeah. That 5-3 was not good at all. Or the previous 5-3 that I did. But now is my chance to save a ton of time. Even if I don't get the lock on this guy, which is actually quite hard, I'm still gonna have a good shot at saving time so long as I don't just die. Oh, I got it! Okay, I'm gonna grab a pause just so that I have it. But that was an awesome run on that. 2 minutes saved! Yeah, that's like one of the toughest things in the game, actually. Cause there's just so many of them, and there's so little. And you need to, like, hit the guy 5 times, and they can get in the way of your hits. So, yeah, that was very good. You know, I just remember that I still need to turn up my sound. And this is like where it starts, where I need to start using the sound. In fact, the lack of sound actually screwed me over in the last stage. Simply because, or the last two stages, because I wasn't able to hear the dust herder shoot this stuff at me. So yeah, I should probably get on that. Sorry, someone came in. I forgot to put on the Do Not Disturb sign. The fire lizard didn't die after 6 hits? It's because I have the fire sweeper. And that sweeper is strong versus the water slugs, but weak versus the lizard. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. The reason that I keep the fire sweeper rather than go for the water sweeper is because, in general, there's not enough gold in the run. Because then you need to repurchase the water sweeper for this level, and then you need to repurchase the fire sweeper for the next level, or the next round. And then you need to repurchase the water sweeper for four devours, and that comes out to about another 6,000 gold in the run, which there isn't enough of. So I save money by just using this, considering both of the fire slugs, or the combustosaurs in this level, aren't very threatening. Unlike the four devours ones, and the water slugs in the water slugs in general, actually. Where they just can move towards you. There we go. Yep, I have enough for one of those. Time warp. Yeah. Low sound is not very good. Now I can hear really clearly. So that's good. Before, like, at most, I could hear the time control music, like, in the background. Like, little glimpses of it. But now this is, like, full-on music. I can hear all the sound effects. Generally awesome. Thank you. cool to rely on auto-aim specifically for this room. Generally, it can be a hindrance. But in that room, it saves me a bit of time because that's like the laggiest room in the game. So I can just direct all of my attention away and then just hit the R button a bunch. Did you see the Mulgon, like, in the background? It acted kind of weird. Like, it popped its head up, dug into the ground, and I think it directly popped its head up back again. Anyways, I'm gonna need to grab one of these bombs so that I can hit the Duster. Okay, so the bomb missed. So I guess I'm gonna need to sacrifice a couple hundred gold. Wait, what'd you miss? Was it when I was explaining the room with, like, all those octoballoons? Cause it's the room that has, like, 5 octoballoons in it that are all just blue. In case you know that room. I think it's still the same in the normal version, but can't really know for sure. I haven't really tested that specific part out. Or checked that specific part out. That's like one of the few doors that I can just jump out of the door. Oh, the mole thing. Yeah, it was like blinking and miss and it was really hidden, but it definitely didn't look correct. Anyway, it's gonna shoot this first because last time the super bomb got in the way. Or that got in the way of the super bomb. Oh! Gotta stay away. Didn't want to blow it. Luckily, it still got the entire room. Didn't need to pick up a fast forward. That was completely accidental. The Mulgon just popped up in the trash. What's up with the Mulgons right now? That are just acting so weird. Also, I didn't bring an extra trash. That's not good. That means that I need to use the time ball if I want to stay on the cart. Yeah, I'm gonna use it. Gold is gonna become much less of a concern starting Everwinter because... just because it kinda gets easier. Like, once you get to Everwinter, you don't exactly need much gold for that stage specifically, other than the 4 spike balls on the Hydrosaur. But other than that, that entire stage is like just a gold farm. Anyways, this guy is pretty easy. There's not really much to him. Just like, get behind him every single time he jumps around. Easiest time to get behind him is during the build. Gonna go for a retry there because I want to get the 2 rewinds here. Just in case. Didn't lose me much time anyway, so that's good. Ah, that's not good. Accidentally activated him. That was a bad jump. Shouldn't have jumped there. But now I know where he's gonna appear, so that's good. I was hoping it would replace the fast forward, since I don't exactly need that yet. But it replaced the... one of the slows instead. Hopefully I can get, like, another slow sometime soon. Thank you. Ooh. Blew everyone up. Thankfully, everyone was in range. You know, that actually works out well. Because I have four pauses now, so I don't need to worry about using the slows. Since at this point, they're just kind of both interchangeable. That's unfortunate. There we go. I remember there being like two retries here. Or two retry crystals. I don't think that's gonna hit. Oh, it hit. Sweet. Does it drop a retry? Yes. Going for it then. Also grabbing gold because I'm literally already there. Pretty good. I skipped the time holder in World 5, I think, so I'm grabbing the time holder here to make up for that. Backflips! You never want to do them. Luckily this time I have extra rewinds. But unfortunately the game did not rewind me back far enough. So I'm just gonna restart. And you know what? It's still better than the last run. There we go. awesome. So many retries. I forgot that the spike doors have hitboxes! Gonna carefully maneuver so that I don't get hit by it this time. Huh. That cat medal is gonna be important when I start going for all medals. I want to try to go into that category once I get sub 2 hour in this. Seems like the spiker has fallen down, so might as well take this guy out while he respawns. I've got all the fast forwards that I need, but I do need another rewind. Specifically for Raid 2. The Typhoon's gonna be the first thing that I wanna shoot, so I'm just gonna get that one bit of trash first. And this is one of the stages where I'm going to want to grab every single piece of trash that I see, because otherwise things will end poorly, especially at the end. Thank you. There are a couple more things that I want to grab over here. Well, if I know something, it's to take out the spiker first, because that's one of the few things that don't give me trash in this whole room. That, the gatekeeper, which is the first thing that I take out, like, just in general, so that the octoballoons can generate trash and shoot at me while they do that. And with that, I definitely have enough trash to take out the rest of the room. Oh no! Well, that kind of moved out of my way. Kind of need to stay on the ground this time. There we go. There's a giant log here. Gonna grab it for the extra 60 gold. Cause I'm not sure how much I have right now, and I wanna make sure that I have enough for the spike ball. Whoa! Where'd I lose 2 minutes in the past run? Oh, I definitely have enough. But I don't know how I got, like, such a good gold split there. That's pretty incredible. You know, please tell me that that doesn't mean that they come out of my inventory. I'm pretty sure it doesn't mean it. But I need those spike balls. Just let the animation play here. Good, they're still here. You know, in my run last time, the run that I was trying to do yesterday, I got to the boss rush, and I accidentally jumped onto the giant platform while he was doing his move where he sinks everything, and as a result, he sunk the giant platform, and that ended up with me needing to not restart, luckily, but I needed to beat him, like, on one of these smaller areas, and then jump to the other You know, if this guy can cooperate, I need to jump to the gold gate. That's what I wanted to say. Oh, come on! This is literally the worst thing that can happen right now. Whoop! I'm getting out of that area, because apparently he's just gonna keep shooting trash. Trash that I just do not need. Yeah. There we go, now he's cooperating. I didn't know what was up before. He was, in fact. At least after that, the battle was smooth sailing. Nothing really bad happened afterwards. Though I did lose, like, a minute.
Just because he did all of that.
Accidentally went onto the exit rather than the pay that I wanted to. But it's all good now. I'm gonna grab extra fast forward because that invincibility on the fast forward can be useful at basically any time possible. Especially in this world where things are always flying at you and all this molten metal is trying to destroy you. Awesome, didn't get hurt. Tom-tong gang guy there. Shoot him. Wanna take out the typhoon before I even think about the other guys. And I need to think about not getting hit by the energy, electricity, whatever. In fact, I'm just not gonna go in that general area. Also, that's kind of why I don't like the auto aim. Because it's directly going there. So as a result, I need to, like, go into this section here. Which I don't really want to do. I don't understand why the auto-aim went in that direction. And why this one spiker is just generally being a pain. If anything, at least I learned the pattern for this specific area here. That's good. There we go.
Yeah. The reason that I learned the FF skip was actually because of that stage. Like, I was trying to figure out a way to get around the whole I was trying to figure out a way to get around the whole lack of gold thing. Not lack of gold thing. Okay, let me gather my thoughts first. Okay, so I was trying to get around getting a cat medal in that one lava pit where you need to press the button and then run across while the lava's there, and then potentially use maybe a rewind or a slow or a pause to keep the lava there. And I couldn't figure out a way to go around the cat medal, so I needed to, like, think about how I would... I haven't even gotten my thoughts. The general summary. I'm just gonna stop trying, because I just cannot get these words out. Anyways, I need to get as much gold as possible in this level, because I only have 616, and I know that I need at least 1550 coming up. I believe this is a level with a gold chest in it, so that's good. I feel kind of absent-minded right now. Like, at this point, I know exactly what I need to do in the run in order to finish it, but I'm still, like, not exactly in the zone and, like, thinking properly. So I might be a little bit surprised with some things in the stage, even though I've already prepared for it, like that one gear, those gears over there. Like, I completely forgot about them before I saw them out of the corner of the vision. But it's no problem. Forgot that guy moved. Yeah, you described it right. The new metal scene. Avoiding that. Thank you. Anyways, hopefully I have enough gold. It actually looks like I don't. That's a problem. How much gold do I have? Yeah, I need gold. This is probably the fastest boss that'll give me enough gold that I need. And I'm pretty confident that doing this will be faster than doing the level out itself, because that one spiker area takes a long time. So now I basically need to do this guy as fast as possible. I know I'm gonna be losing time on this split as a result, but this is better than the alternative of having actually no gold. Huh. Okay. I will not go that close to him this time. Okay, there we go. Now I just need to position myself and I'll have enough gold for the skip. Unfortunate that I need to go to that boss, because that's surely going to lose me time on the next split. But I have to do it. Oh well. Why I have extras. Good. That extra 100 gold would be nice, but I need to expel everything else, so I won't go for it. Might as well grab the record. It can come very useful as a backup strat for the next boss. And since I have 3 fast forwards, I don't need to worry about messing this up. As I said, good thing I have 3 fast forwards. There we go. Huh. I'll take that extra 100 G though. Huh. Only lasts 45 seconds, which is actually better than I was expecting. Anyways, next thing. I don't want to be down retries on this next boss. Technically toughest boss in the game. Even though, funnily enough, I think his easier version is harder. Just for this run, though. Casually, this guy is... Well, he's definitely in hell, that's for sure. Time controls are pretty good against this boss, but seeing as they spend, it takes up time to use them because of, like, the little animation at the end where it goes like 3, 2, 1, go. Because of that, I try not to use them in the run. I will use them if I feel like I have to, though. And I almost felt like I had to use it there. Because if anything, that little bit is not as bad as a time loss as the retry itself. Okay, I definitely have enough trash to finish the fight. The problem is, where are the little guys? There they are. Generally at this point, they're all like, close together. And for some reason, teleported over here. Okay, so I do not have enough to finish the fight. That was very close. But now I need to worry about this guy rolling at me. Of course, it's fine now because I can shoot him. But Not gonna be too close to him, because that ending actually has a hurtbox until he goes down into the ground. And it's really mean. Still saved a couple seconds, though. Overall, it was a pretty good run. I'm gonna buy one spike ball. Wanna save up the money for the spike balls at the end, where I need a lot of them to beat up the boss. And it's not like they carry over through the boss rush anyway. I'm saving the spike ball for the end. I shot him twice. Three. Well, that's no good. Oh, come on! That's not good at all! Okay. Losing a bit of time here. Whoops! That is not the end of the lock. Or that's not the end of the split. It's force of habit, actually. Like, once you get through everything, each specific one is a really long split, or a really short split, and then you get to the boss rush, and that alone is, like, the longest split. This is the only time where I'll use, like, a time control, because there aren't enough platforms in the level for you to hit him normally. So I'll do that just to make sure that I do get him. Of course, I do need to think about the fact that I need 8 trash pieces to kill him, and I've only gotten 3 so far. So I need to pop him out of the water to shoot trash 3 times. It's a lot easier in the earlier rounds. Well, that's no good. Now the one time where I do want him to shoot trash, he's not shooting trash. Wonderful. Okay, that's good. I need him to shoot trash one more time, though. That's annoying. How do I keep missing? This is not looking very good. This is actually quite a bad run of this boss. Luckily, there's the trash that I need. Though I'm gonna stay away from that specific area because I remember what happened last time.
Three.
I'm not entirely sure that this will be a good boss rush run, but at this point, beating this guy is kind of just formulaic, so that's good. Just takes two more hits to take him out. That's nice. Mostly without hits, this boss has gone. Not sure why I grabbed the two pauses there. I don't actually need them. I was about to say that that doesn't help me in the least, but then I missed, so that does help me in the greatest. And that was a That's the worst thing about this boss. The fact that that can happen. Luckily, it didn't happen the second time there, though it was very close to happening. Luckily, I can just, like, refill on retries here. I'm gonna have enough trash, though the fact that I missed two there is not very good. I need to stop doing that. I really need to stop doing that, because that's losing me like 5-7 seconds every time that I miss. I'm only gonna shoot when I'm sure that I'm behind him now. There we go. Now grab his gold because it seems like he's just the highest gold yield of all the bosses. And he's actually one of the easier bosses, faster bosses, and like one of the easiest to like stand where the gold is gonna come out because it's telegraphed so much and he like shrinks down to like pinpoint size. That's annoying. That's annoying too. Okay, I'm kinda just gonna be quiet for now, cause this can go kinda bad if I'm not careful. This can go really bad if I'm not careful. This is scary. Don't come in here. Sorry. Got distracted. This is frustrating right now. I'm gonna start losing time soon. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start letting him jump and detonate the bomb. Because there is the chance that I can get them like that. And that saves me trash. And the time of, like, hunting them around. You know, that's actually saving a lot of time doing that. Interesting. Finally, he stopped blowing. Yeah. I'm gonna pause here. That was mean. I was expecting him to not be so close. I have to be cautious. No? I saw myself almost slip into there. I am not letting that happen right at the end here. That could have been actually the run engine. Anyways, let's get on to the final boss. Doesn't look like I'm gonna be below 2 hours. But, you know, this is still going well. Okay, first phase done. Sweet. I'm gonna wait for more time control or crystals to fall before I start deciding which one to go for. Because right now there's one slow, fast forward, and record. Okay, there's two fast forwards, two records. I should be high enough. Oh! You know, it's disappointing that the crystal that's there the most is the one that isn't even a time control. Okay, now I have one more pause. I literally have two of every crystal here. Okay, found a rewind, finally. Oh! Backflips. You never want them. Except except for that one time where it clipped through. Oh, that's not good. I messed up there. Whoa! Okay, I still have invincibility. That was hilarious. Okay, I can grab record next. And then fast forward. You know, I think that's high enough. It was not high enough. I need to start, like, focusing a lot more. Also, I can actually grab a quick two retries here. Okay, slow this time. So, I should be safe. I don't need to prepare much for here. That's actually kind of annoying. That was paused, I remember seeing that. Okay, that's definitely high enough. Good. Okay, they blew stuff up. Okay, there we go. Now, basically just free. Time! Let's go! 204! 5 minutes shaved off, that's pretty awesome. And also a gold split on the last boss. I'm gonna post this run to Reddit. Hopefully it can introduce people to the game, and then we can see more people, like, starting to run this game. Cause... And now that I'm not just doing, like, casual plays like I did back, like, a year or so ago, where really it was just me doing the normal level as fast as possible with no really big alterations. Now that I have, like, I have the clip, I have basically all of the places where I use bombs, I have... What else do I have? You know, that's actually kind of about it for... for all of the tricks in the speedrunning. But yeah, hopefully more people would be able to come. Yeah. Hey Zobel, are you on speedruns.com? Or speedrun.com? That site... It's probably where most of the Blinks information currently is. I can link it to you in the chat.
One second.
Oh.
Well, if you're already there, then.
I guess I don't need to. So, yeah. I think in order to do a run that's below 2 hours, I think I need to start finding a little bit more and experimenting with the game and figuring out where I can save, like, a bunch of time. Because right now, I feel like that run was really good. Aside from the 4 seconds, or the 4 minutes that I lost on the boss rush, like, because of the death on the Forge of Hours boss, the time wasted on both the Karragon and the Hydrosaur, etc., etc., I think that it's still possible to do sub 2 hours. It's just gotta be, like, a nearly perfect run of the game, as it is right now. So I'm gonna start experimenting a bit more, and I'm probably gonna leave any percent off for, like, a little bit so that I can focus a bit more on all metals, because that's something that I want to try out. I'm interested in how I can do that, and, like, routing that and stuff. It's also interesting because this was actually my first run of the day. Like, not even any early resets before. I think maybe... This might be the second one, but like, the first one I just completely screwed up on Times Square 2. So, interesting that there was like, barely any practice going into this. Anyways, I'm gonna stop the stream now. Hope you had a good time. I'll see you later. I'll just wait for this cutscene, because why not? Might as well make it complete.
Zerbom Seacraft Ma. Struxam.
D. Seroas